Before we get into the show, we would like to remind you that this is a live event, meaning there is a live comment section.
You're all welcome to express your love and support for all of our wonderful performers.
But please keep in mind that the chat is being monitored. Keep it civil, CB.
Mr. Hogan is watching you.
Have fun and enjoy the show.
Hello, everyone.
And welcome to CB's fourth and final open mic night of the school year.
And this is also our first virtual open mic.
So thank you to everyone who's tuning in to watch the show tonight.
Grace, what you got on over there?
I like the St. Francis jersey.
Oh, shoot. This isn't right.
All right. We're pretending that didn't happen, but it's okay because, you know, stranger things have happened on Zoom calls.
It was an honest mistake. I'm better now.
Do not revert to your old ways.
Oh, moving on. How is everyone? I miss you guys.
It's been a little chaotic with AP tests and wrapping up the end of the year, but enough about this hell year. Tonight, we're taking a break from that for a bit.
That's right. Tonight, we are celebrating the class of 2020.
Along with the many talented faces in the CB community that will be performing.
And despite being apart, it's important to remember that we're still here together to celebrate the community as well as the senior class.
Exactly. And to start us off tonight, who better than
the Kendama Mamas performing Dancing in the Moonlight.
What do you think, Teddy?
I agree. Pretty fantastic.
The Kendama Mamas is a band made up of Asher Bloom, Rafa Fernandez, Daniel Larson Anderson, and John Bonini. I walked in on Daniel practicing one time. Let me tell you, it's a little fishy to catch someone playing the bass in a shark onesie. But he's definitely done weirder. Up next, we have Ani Urias ready to serenade you with a piano cover of Finesse by Bruno Mars, Ashton Smith performing an original poem, and Francesca Eisler asking you to stay.
I have everywhere to go but cannot choose a path. I feel like the future is leaving me behind. But as soon as I find my footing, I'll hit the ground running. At least that's the goal. Even though I'm graduating from one stage of life to the next, I don't know where to go. So I'm staying here, stuck in the same place I've always been. I want to make it. I want to spread my wings into the great blue sky that is my future. It just takes a leap of faith. And I don't know if I have the courage. I'm being thrust into the world and I don't know what to do. I mean, I didn't learn about any of this in history or in Algebra 2. I guess I'll have to figure it out as I go. Good thing I know how to improvise. I really don't know what I'm doing. And I honestly didn't even know I'd make it this far. But as a kid, I dreamed of working my dream job, having close friends, being free to go on road trips. As a kid, I wasn't scared. Facing life takes a certain kind of bravery. Being scared of talking to the cashier behind the counter or making eye contact with a potential employer. I'm scared, but I have to. Because damn it, I really want my chapstick and a job at Bel Air. I don't know if I have the courage to take that leap of faith. And I don't know if it's brave or stupid, but I'm going to jump anyway. Because this is the start of a life that I've dreamed of since I was a kid. I have friends and I have freedom. And damn it, I want to live my life. So I'm facing everything, walking forward into a future I will make my own.
Hey Falcons, my name is David, I'm from the class of 2018, and as some of you may remember, a few years ago I was an open mic coordinator, and I hope you're all doing well. Now, before I introduce the next few acts, I just wanted to give a few quick shout-outs. First, to the Open Mic Club and to everyone who helped put this show together. Everyone watching this is very grateful for your efforts, so thank you. Next, to the wonderful Miss Shorn, thank you for doing a great job keeping Open Mic Club up and running. And finally, some words for the class of 2020. Including my amazing younger sister. You've all worked very hard over the past 4 years. You should be proud of yourselves, and don't you dare tell yourself otherwise. Unfortunately, I do not own a purple shirt, so these purple streamers are the best I could do to honor you. Anyways, that's enough from me. Get ready for some fantastic performances. Next up is Elaine singing a beautiful rendition of Somewhere Over the Rainbow. After that, Miss Yearwood has a lovely message for CB, followed by a performance of The Rose. And then we have an instrumental performance of New York, New York from JC and Thea, followed by CB's very own Mr. Jackson singing When You Wish Upon a Star.
Bye. Hey, Christian Brothers, it's Miss Yearwood. I thought that I would share a little something with you for open mic night. I'm sorry that we can't all be together, but I'm thinking a lot about you and hope that this is something that you enjoy. The rose has always been one of my favorite flowers. There's the old adage about stopping to smell the roses, and whenever I'm able to do so, I always stop. Because I love the majestic colors of the rose, I love the beautiful fragrance that they provide. There's just something really majestical about watching a rose start out as a small bud and turn into a full blossom. I love a beautiful rose. The life cycle of the rose can be related to our own lives. We can go through phases of growth and pruning and some rough winters that can leave us bare, but in the end, we, like the roses, will regrow and prosper. There's a quote that I love by Paulo Coelho, who is the author best known for his novel, The Alchemist. And this is what he says. The rose is a rose from the time it is a seed to the time it dies. Within it, at all times, it contains its whole potential. It seems to be constantly in the process of change. Yet, at each state, at every moment, it is perfectly all right, just as it is. This is my message, especially for you tonight, seniors, as you stand prepared to embark into new horizons, that within you at all times is contained your whole potential. I would love to be able to present each of you with a bouquet like these beautiful roses here, with all of the symbolic beauty and the message of love that is contained in each one of these flowers. But since I cannot share that gesture with you at this time, instead I thought I would offer you the gift of a song. The song I'd like to share with you and dedicate to you, especially seniors, the class of 2020, is called The Rose.
Yeah. becomes
I hope you're enjoying the show. In case you've missed any of the earlier acts, not to worry, this will be uploaded to YouTube after the live stream. But up next, we have our very own Miss Christensen with a rewrite of the Cup Song. And since I can't say it in person, I will say it here. Thank you so much, Miss Christensen, not just for the beautiful song, but for everything you do to help make Open Mic possible throughout the year. And after Miss Christensen's performance, we have a fantastic original song by our very own Frankie Pinuela. It's called You Love Him. And then following Frankie's performance, we have another original song by the wonderful Audrey Solis called Not Out of Luck.
Semester has been really rough. Not my favorite, I won't lie. But you've conquered class online. You're so tough, it blows my mind. And I'm so proud that I could cry. Life goes on, life goes on. I'll miss you when you move on. I'm so proud of you, my friends. Hope you'll visit when this ends. And I'll miss you when you move on.
Down in the air. bones broken and skin torn apart. Watch me as I fell too far. And still, your love fell. Your love fell. Your love fell. I'm innocent. Your love.
This is an original song. A horrific storm strikes on winter with no fear. Breezy ashes we hold dear. Out of fire and right to our door. Open up all your windows. White flags shine in rainbow skies. And we don't have to stay inside. After all of the fires are out. But be careful now. 'Cause we're not all out. Stop looking down. I don't.
Next up, we have the fabulous Hannah Makelem performing Remember Me. All right, what a great performance by Hannah. And next up, we have Jack Flynn, so please give it up.
What's it like to be alone on a Sunday, remembering the time you saw them just yesterday? Sing me a song, tell me your thoughts, I could listen to you all night long, 'cause I don't about my sleeping routine. I messed it up as it is, but we've got so much time to kill. This night rocks me to sleep. Short to worry about things.
it's cold and my thoughts feel like stone, and it's nothing I can't change, but I can't breathe anymore. I forgot how to walk by myself. I could do with a little more of your help. Life's too short to worry about things we got wrong. Hug all your friends and let them know you're not letting go, 'cause I'm not letting go. Life's too short to worry about things we got wrong. So hug all your friends, let them know you're not letting go. I won't let go. Oh, 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 oh.
What a great performance from Jack. And next on the list is Andres Sanchez. Please give it up for Andres.
Like the perfect time for some nostalgia-filled reflection.
So, like, a game?
Exactly.
Do we need an intermission game in this digital format?
I don't see why not. Let's stick with tradition. What are the rules?
I think it's going to be two truths and a lie. Instead of it being about us, it's going to be about some crazy events that happened in 2020.
Featuring some special guests that some of you lovely viewers may recognize. Drum roll, please.
Care to introduce yourselves?
Hi.
Hello.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, we're introducing ourselves right now?
Yes, introduce yourself.
Okay. You're Izzy. I graduated last year. Allie and I were former open mic hosts, and now we live at home.
Yeah. I went to Santa Clara University, and Izzy went to University of Portland, and that's where we've been vibing for the past couple of months until now.
What's your major, Allie?
I'm a psychology major. What's your major, Izzy?
I'm French and economics.
Nice. How about we kick it over to Miss Priya?
Hi, I'm Priya. I'm a senior. Do I have to say my major? Okay, I was gonna say. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Now it's Haley's turn.
Oh, hi. Hello. My name is Haley. I'm also a senior. Let's kick it off to Leah.
Abby?
What?
Or Abby?
I have to introduce myself?
No, there's a script.
Oh! Okay.
I think this is
So the rules, two truths and a lie, we're going to list three events.
Each of you will tell us which two you think are true and which one you think is the lie.
Feel free to play along with your families at home. Tell us how many you get right in the comments.
Now, without further ado, let's begin.
I don't know current events.
Okay, so first set. Two truths and a lie. Here are my things. Mr. Peanut, the Planters mascot, has passed away, sadly, in the year 2020. Number two, Chet Hanks, son of Tom Hanks, caught coronavirus. Number three, the public learned of Dr. Phil's Nightmare Mansion.
Can you repeat
them? Can you repeat the last one?
I'll repeat.
I didn't get that.
I'll repeat them. So, first, Mr. Peanut, the mascot for Planters Nuts, passed away in 2020. Two, Chet Hanks, son of Tom Hanks, caught coronavirus. Three, the public learned of Dr. Phil's Nightmare Mansion.
Oh, learned. Okay.
Yeah,
learned. I think it's got to be the peanut thing. Because
I wasn't aware that the Peanut Man was a real person. I thought he was just...
Peanuts are immortal. You can't, like, a peanut...
I go Dr. Phil.
I've been studying that too. Tom Hanks thing. Mm-hmm. I know that Grace cares way too much about it, so I'm going to go with that. I feel like it's the
okay.
Hanks one.
So, Priya, which one do you think is the lie?
The second one.
Okay. Haley, which one do you think is the lie?
The Dr. Phil one.
Allie, which one do you think is the lie?
Peanuts are immortal. Peanuts can't die.
Izzy, which one do you think is the lie?
Dr. Phil.
Okay, so.
Doesn't exist.
True. True. The mascot for Planters Nuts, Mr. Peanut, passed away in 2020. And was replaced by, I think it's called Baby Nut.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. So oh my god. I know what you're talking about. I know what you're talking about.
It was like a Super Bowl commercial.
Yep. Yep. Okay. Also true. The public learned of Dr. Phil's Nightmare Mansion.
What does it do? What is it?
What does that entail?
He has many, many, many guns hanging on his wall. A dark purple color scheme. And anyway, it's just like, it's very interestingly decorated and it's kind of frightening. There's a lot of bones.
I haven't checked BuzzFeed in a while. Oh my god.
He is a forensic psychologist.
Oh.
So.
Maybe that's
for thought.
Anyway, so the only one who got that round right was Priya. She knows that I have an obsession
with this one. Baby Nut in my purple background.
You just really like Tom Hanks' son. It's just like a fact.
I just think it's funny that his name is Chet and he looks like a Chet. Okay.
All right. Ready for a second?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right. Number one, murder hornets have invaded the U.S. Number two, eels in a Chinese aquarium are forgetting that people exist and need to be FaceTimed. Number three, no colleges will be accepting this year's AP exams in the light of the pandemic's impact on schools.
It's gotta be the AP.
It's gotta be the eels.
I read an article about
why would they make you take the test then if they aren't gonna count it?
Isn't it like optional, like the SAT, like how they don't require it, but they're saying like it can add to your application?
Do you want me to repeat them or do you think
I think the eels. I don't believe eels need face.
Wait, it was eels? Okay. I think it's the eels one because I read about fish. I know eels are fish, but not an eel, like a fish.
I will, just to be consistent, I'm going to go with the first one about the murder hornets because I also don't believe in hornets.
I want to choose the first one just because I refuse to believe that they're real. I don't want to acknowledge it. Yeah,
you're
I like
manifest
that answer.
One.
I think they're just larger than life bees.
I just want to manifest that they're not real. Yeah.
People exist. Are just putting a magnifying glass up to bees.
Yeah, they're all just fake images.
Not that big.
Okay, I didn't create these, so according to Grace, this is Grace who created these.
I'm right.
Murder hornets have indeed invaded the U.S.
Ugh.
Eels also need to be FaceTimed.
Yep. FaceTime them.
They need to be FaceTimed. Thankfully, the false one is that colleges will be accepting. Well, the false one is that colleges won't be accepting AP scores, meaning they will be accepting AP scores.
Okay, that makes sense.
Uh-huh. Oh, for two.
Yeah. Good for me.
Yeah, uh-huh. Round three. Got any right.
I don't like murder hornets. All right,
round three.
Neither do I.
Number one.
It's popular opinion, Allie.
Round three. Number one. Kevin Bacon has decided to re-release Footloose, but with all his scenes done by him currently. Number two, John Krasinski hosted a public digital prom. And number three, Grimes and Elon Musk have had a baby, and the proud couple named their child X Ash Archangel, spelled like this.
I hate that I know that one.
I know that one.
There's too many TikToks I've seen.
Too many memes about it. There are too many memes. I can't.
The John Krasinski one's a lie because I read a story somewhere that he officiated a wedding, but it wasn't a prom. There was a John Krasinski story, though. I see Grace's face. That means I'm right.
I go with Allie.
It's like, I feel like it's the first one.
What was the first one again?
The Kevin Bacon one. But I want that one to be true because it was so specific.
Yeah, also, what about the scenes that he's with other people? Is he just gonna like green screen it?
Is Kevin Bacon?
I wish he would do that.
The really athletic dance where he's like skiing on chains?
Yeah.
The second one?
I don't
know. No, I'm pretty sure that's Kevin Bacon when he like he does the dance when he's upset.
And he like,
yeah.
Yeah, it's the angry dance. That should be real. I'm gonna go with the second one with John Krasinski's The Pulse.
Yeah, I feel like the Kevin Bacon one should be real. So because of that, I'm going to choose the John Krasinski one.
I say Bacon.
I go against more Bacon. He's more boring than Kevin Bacon.
Final answers?
I am not Bacon. Bacon, so I pick number one.
Krasinski.
Bacon.
Number one is right. Bacon. Kevin Bacon will Bacon. Not be recording Footloose. John Krasinski did allegedly host a digital prom, and Grimes and Elon Musk have named their baby that.
0-3.
Anyway, thank you guys so much for participating in our game.
Was that the whole game?
Yeah, we only had three rounds.
Okay.
Oh.
Haley, did you get anything right?
I got the last one right.
Yeah.
Can you imagine if we released Footloose? I would cry.
It would be so great. Honestly, to see him dance alone. Oh my gosh. I hope he does it.
What?
Priya, how many did you get right?
One.
Oh. So you guys are tied for first place.
You guys would have got straight zeros.
Did you get none, Allie?
Huh? Yeah, no, I didn't get any.
Oh my god.
That's okay. I still don't think Baby Ned exists.
Baby Ned. I've seen Baby Ned, though. I've Mm-mm. seen him.
It's pretty disturbing. Yeah.
Conspiracy theory. Yeah.
It was like weird. I don't know why they didn't just change the mascot. Like why there was a whole backstory. It was like Mr. Peanut has to die for Baby Nut to take his place.
Mr. Peanut didn't die. He's a mortal.
Right.
Anyway, and everyone hates Baby Nut. There's a lot of discourse.
Why did they pick that?
You can't hate on something that doesn't exist.
It's a lot of manifesting on the Zoom call right now.
Yeah.
So, do you guys have anything to say to the class of 2020 or the other open mic participants?
I miss you. I miss you all. I hope that this was entertaining. I don't know.
Thank you, class of 2020, for all the memories.
Thank you, class of 2020, for all the memories.
Thank you guys for listening and watching and for, I don't know, just vibing during this time. I know it's probably really hard. Just thank you for watching.
Okay, thank you guys so much for participating. I hope you guys had a good time.
Once again, we would like to thank our guest stars for joining us on that game. Up next, we have two acts wildly different in tone, but equally powerful and creative. First up, we have Magdalena Bowen performing Forever Young. followed by Logan Tiska with a rendition of Eminem's Lose Yourself.
Look, if you had one shot, one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted, one moment, would you capture it? Just let it slip. Yo, his palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy, he's vomit on a sweater already, mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd grows so loud. He opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking now. Everybody's joking now. The clock's run out. Time's up. Over. Blow. Snap back to reality. Over goes gravity. Over goes gravity. He's so mad, but he won't give up that. As he know he won't have it. He knows his old back to this ropes. It don't matter. He's dope. He knows that, but he's broke. He's so stagnant. He knows when he goes back to this mobile home. That's when he's back to the lab again, yo. This whole rap city better could capture this moment and hope you don't. You better lose yourself in the music the moment you want it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You better lose yourself in the music the moment you want it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. The soul's escaping through this hole that is gaping. This world is mine for the taking. Make me king as we move toward a new world order. A normal life is born, but superstardom is close to postmodern. It only grows harder, homie grows harder. He blows us all over, these girls is all on him. Coast to coast shows he's known as a globetrotter. Lonely Rose God only knows he's grown father. From home he's no father. He goes home and he barely knows his own daughter. But hold your nose, cause here goes the cold water. These girls don't want him no more. He's cold product. They moved on to the next smoke who flows and nose dove and sold nada. So the soap opera is told and unfolds. I suppose it's old partner, but the beat goes on. Da 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 da. Lose yourself in the music the moment you want it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity goes once in a lifetime. You better lose yourself in the music the moment you want it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity goes once in a lifetime. No more games, I'ma change what you call rich. Shade this freaking roof off like two dogs cage. I was playing in the beginning. The mood up changed. I've been chewed up and spit out and booed off stage. But I kept rhyming a step right in the next cipher. Best believe somebody's paying the Pied Piper. All the pain inside amplified by the fact that I can't get by with my 9 to 5 and I can't provide the right type of life for my family. Cause man, these gosh dang food stamps to buy diapers. And it's no movie, there's no Mekhi Pfeiffer. This is my life when the times are so hard. And it's getting even harder, try to feed and water my seed. Plus teeter-totter caught in between being a father and a prima donna. Baby mama drama screaming at her too much for me. Don't wanna stand in one spot. Another day of monotony's got me to the point I'm like a snail. I've got to formulate a plot or end up in jail or shot. Success is my only freaking option. Failure's not, mama love you, but this trailer's got to go. I cannot grow old in Salem's lot. So here I go, is my shot. Fate fail me not, this may be the only opportunity that I got. You better lose yourself in the music the moment you own it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity goes once in a lifetime. You better lose yourself in the music the moment you own it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity goes once in a lifetime. You can do anything you set your mind to, man.
Hey there, open mic fans. It's Mr. Anderson here at the Anderson Quarantine Headquarters, aka the Penthouse Suite. It's time for our final set of performers for the evening. And I gotta say, this is a pretty solid way to close out open mic for the class of 2020. Some of our most talented students taking the stage, the virtual stage, for you guys. First up, we have Isabella Coleman and Amy Glum performing Shallow, a personal favorite of mine. Grab the tissues. It's definitely an emotional one. After that, we have one of the great songbirds of her generation, Emily Hancock, performing Cardinal. Definitely looking forward to hearing one of Emily's fantastic performances. And then closing out the show, the dynamic duo of Lolis Isara Larivel and Asher Bloom performing Put Your Records On. I know that after watching tonight's show, I'm going to be putting some records on at home because I will be inspired by all of the great performances. Speaking of inspiration, the class of 2020, you guys have been awesome. You've been a great group of kids. I've really enjoyed personally having so many of you in class over the last couple of years and seeing you guys selflessly share your talents, not just on the stage, but in the classroom, on the playing fields, on retreats, all throughout. I'm really going to miss you guys. I think I speak for all of the CB staff when I say that we're going to miss you guys, and we're all looking forward to seeing what's next for you. So thanks for all the performers for performing tonight. Enjoy the performances. Peace. Peace out. Thank you.
you hesitate? Girl, put your records on. Tell me your favorite song. You go ahead, let your hair down. Sapphire faded jeans. I hope you get your dreams. Just go ahead, let your hair down. You're gonna find yourself somewhere, somehow. The sky, summer and lonely. Sipping tea in a bar by the roadside. Just relax, don't you let those other boys fool you. Gotta love that afro hairdo. Maybe sometimes we feel afraid, but it's alright. Strange girl, put your records on. Tell me your favorite song. Just go ahead, let your hair down. Sapphire and faded jeans. I hope you get your dream. Just go ahead, let your hair down. You're gonna find yourself somewhere, somehow. Just more than I could take. Your records on. Tell me your favorite song. You go ahead, let your head down. Sapphire faded jeans. I hope you get your dreams. Just go ahead, let your head down. Girl, put your records on. Tell me your favorite song.
What's next?
Ayla, that's it. That's the show.
Seriously? Well, one way to end the evening.
We'd like to thank you all again for watching the show.
Abby and I are going to miss Open Mic a lot.
But Ayla will be here next year to continue on the time-honored tradition of memorizing the script backstage.
And frantically figuring out what the games are going to be.
And of course, creating a wonderful experience for all of you.
Seriously, CB, these open mics wouldn't be what they are without you, either as participants or in the audience.
Thank you so much again. And also thank you to Ms. Shorn, our wonderful moderator. Thank you to Mr. Hogan, who helped us figure out how to do this in an online format as well as the students. And again, a big thank you to Open Mic Club, the members, and the other officers as well.
We'll get through this together, CB.
Good night.